the more I dug into that stupid little rape crew case, right? The more I dug into it, I started reading the facts of the case. And I'm going to tell you something right now. It is amazing that the whole city officials are not charged right now with conspiracy of a cover-up of all this bullshit going on. If you read the whole facts of that case from the prosecutor being Jane Hamlin, whose son is also being implicated in this rape case, the rape crew, it is a crime right now how the FBI, I think they're involved now, how they weren't involved earlier, but how that these people, the officials of that city, are not indicted and have charges brought upon them. This case here is a whole thing to save the football program, but also to save the kids of the parents, their kids that went on that football team. They don't want to destroy that program. It's worse than the Jerry Sandusky case. I got news for you right now. It is, because this whole town is corrupt. The city officials, they are corrupt as hell right now and trying to cover this up since August. In fact, when the girl went with her parents to press charges, to file charges, she was talked out of it, or they tried to dissuade her from pressing charges by Jane Hamlin herself, the prosecuting attorney right now, because she said her name would be drugged through the mud, this and that, for weeks, years, this and that. But the people didn't care. They wanted charges filed. She tried to curtail them from filing charges. And let me say this right now. Thank God for fucking Anonymous, because if it wasn't for Anonymous doing their due diligence right now, this shit would have been swept under the rug. No one would have had any charges on them, and these punks would have got away with this shit. But I'm going to tell you something right now. It's not being swept under the rug right now. Anonymous keeps on pushing the issue, which thank God they are. We need to bring justice. A fucking 15-year-old girl was raped, pissed on, drugged from house to house, sodomized, whatever. And you know what? These people don't give a shit. They just care about their football program. And it's a crime right now. I believe everybody involved in that, trying to cover it up, I don't care, city officials, whatever, should be brought up on charges right now and prosecuted to the fullest extent right now of the law. This is a crime right now. Here's the thing I got to ask Jane Hamlin. If your son is involved in it, being implicated as a defendant, you know what would happen if that was my son? Number one, I'd handcuff myself and bring him down to the fucking courthouse and say, put him in jail until fucking trial, until he's found guilty, whatever. How you could even try to defend, and we all, if you look at the whole, I'm going to leave you a link right now in this here. I'm going to leave you a link right now. When you go through all the evidence right there, and when you see that, you're going to come to your conclusion, and I know we got to bring it out in court, that's fine. But after you see this, it is amazing how the cover-up going up right now in Steubenville right now, that no one's doing a damn thing about it. Like I said, thank God for Anonymous for bringing the people's attention, because without them, this shit would have got swept under the rug. These punks would have got away with all this bullshit. But we need justice served, because if that was my daughter, and I brought my daughter into that fucking courtroom, whatever, to file charges, and someone tried talking me out of it, I ain't even going to say what would have happened. I ain't even going to say. But I'm going to tell you something right now. If you read up on this link I'm going to give you right now, and like I said, there's a video on the internet they're bragging about. Well, it's total embarrassment for the city of Steubenville. And some of the officials in Steubenville that are good officials that ain't involved in this cover-up should come out right now and say, fuck this, we need to get justice. Because you know what? Football is football. But raping somebody is much bigger than football. And I know people are going to say, how can I say it? It is. Trust me. You cannot go around a 15-year-old girl. Come on, man. But apparently in Steubenville, to keep their football program spot clean, which, by the way, hasn't won nothing since, what, 2005 and 2006, whatever. It's been, what, 7, 8 years? Obviously, you're not doing that good. But let's be honest about it. This needs to be brought. The FBI needs to step in. But I understand they are right now. President Obama needs to step in. This needs to. If you have a corrupt city going on right now trying to cover this up, imagine what else they'd be covering up over there. Lord knows what other stuff could be drug up. Bottom line, this is a fucking crime. And you know, people ask me, why am I involved? I'm not even involved. I just, when I see things bad in society that need fixed, you need to fix it. An eye for an eye. Because I'm going to tell you something right now. One of these times, something's going to happen to someone's daughter or son, and it's going to be a parent like me that's not all they're saying, that's not all their marbles, and there's going to be something, there's going to be hell to pay. So, I'm just trying to prevent a further fucking altercation from something happening, because I'm telling you, something's going to happen one day, and some parent's going to fucking not accept it. He's going to take the law in his own hands right now. And you're not going to have just one girl getting raped. You may have multiple deaths involved. I'm telling you right now, that's why the government right now needs to step inside of this, take a hold of this right now before it gets out of hand. These kids, whoever's involved in covering this up, needs to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law and put down in prison, whatever. And we need to set a precedent right now for the good. Not just to set a precedent for what's right in society. You cannot cover up something to save your fucking city or to save your football team, whatever. Last time I checked, a human life is more valuable than a football fucking team or football program. So like I say, once again, I'm ending the video on this note. Thank God Anonymous got involved, because if they didn't, this shit would have been swept under the rug. These punks would have got off scot-free. No charge would have been brought to them. And they would have done this again. And if you see the YouTube video where they're bragging about what they did, if that was my son in that video, I would personally whoop his ass, bring him down to the court system, and fucking disown his ass. Tell you that right fucking now. A lot of people get to miss it. Look, there's a way in society you handle yourself. I represent all that's good and evil. And what I mean by that is, I'm not evil. I hate evil people. Just a saying that I got. I hate people that are evil, and these kids are evil. I don't care if they're 17, whatever. Last time I checked, when I was 16 years old, I knew what the fuck I was doing. I knew right from wrong. There comes a time when you know right from wrong, and at 16 years old, you know right from wrong. Don't give me that. Well, they were 17, and no. They committed a big boy crime, and they want to charge them as little boys, as they said in that video that I tweeted out earlier. If you rape someone, you know what you're doing, all right? As soon as your dick gets hard, you know what the fuck you know what the fuck you're doing. So you rape someone, you're an adult. You should be charged as an adult. I don't want to hear this shit while they were kids. No, we need to set a fucking example. I'm tired of this shit. This country has gone downhill letting shit like this. And I know people are going to say what happens everywhere. It may. But guess what? We have a way to stop it now. Stop it from happening again in this fucking city. Stop it from ever preventing it from happening again in this city. And let's do that right now. Because what I'm seeing right now out of this whole thing, I had to get the SRTA thing back to, because that's just what I do. But what I'm seeing right now is just a blatant crime of fucking... It's an attribute of fucking sectioning society of fucking scumbags that would allow this shit to cover it up. And it's just bullshit that the people of that community will cover it up. And I know there are probably good people in that community that won't cover it up, but they're probably too scared to come out. You need to stand up. We have support. The FBI will support you. I know people say, well, then the FBI will support you. Trust me. Most people don't want to do a crime anyway because they don't want to go to prison. They're scared to death of prison. So... trust me on that. Now I'm going to leave this video done right now, because I got to get food. But anyway, that's my take on it. The more I indulge myself and study the evidence, the more I said, this is a crime. This is embarrassing how they got away with this. And it angers me, not as a parent, because I'm not a parent, but it just angers me to see that some town could let this corruption go on because of a fucking lousy-ass football program. I don't care if they were good. It doesn't fucking matter. We've already seen what happened at Penn State, how they allowed that shit to go on. Well, guess what? This is where it stopped. The rape stops fucking here.